जीडी बिस्ट लीगल एक्सरसाइज नंबर 53 बी रेडी स्टार्ट द डिवीजन बेंच ऑफ द हाई कोर्ट वाइड इट्स ऑर्डर डेटेड 7th October 2002 अलाउड द अपील ऑफ द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट एंड डिसमिस्ड द सूट ऑफ द एफिलेंट फर्म एंड ऑल्सो डायरेक्टेड दैट द डेक्रिटल अमाउंट डिपॉजिटेड बाय द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट एंड एज परमिटेड टू बी विथड्रॉन बाय द फर्म शुड बी रिफंडेड विद इन ए पीरियड ऑफ 4 months फ्रॉम द डेट ऑफ द जजमेंट प्यारा बींग एग्रीड बाय द सेड जजमेंट द अपीलेंट फर्म हैज फाइल्ड दिस अपील बाय वे ऑफ स्पेशल लीव पिटिशन बिफोर दिस कोर्ट हु हियर्ड मिस्टर अल्ताफ अहमद लर्नेड सीनियर काउंसिल फॉर द अपीलेंट एंड मिसेस माधवी दीवान लर्नेड काउंसिल फॉर द रिस्पोंडेंट स्टेट थ्रू द ट्रायल कोर्ट After accepting the claim of the plaintiff, granted a decree to the extent of ₹2,27,000 with proportionate cost and interest at the rate of 6% per annum from the date of suit till realization in the appeal filed by the state after finding that the plaintiff was stopped from claiming damages against the department as the final bill was accepted. The High Court allowed the appeal of the state and dismissed the suit of the plaintiff. Para, the High Court non-suited the plaintiff mainly on the ground of clauses 8 and 10 of the agreement and of the fact that the final bill was accepted by the plaintiff under protest. In view of the same, it is relevant to refer clauses 8 and 10 of the agreement, which are as follows. Clause 8, number payment shall be made for any work estimated no cost less than 1,000 till after the whole of the said work shall have been completed and a certificate of completion given. But in the case of work estimated in cost more than ₹1,000, the contractor shall, on submitting a monthly bill, therefore be entitled to receive payment proportionate to the part of the work then approved and passed by the engineer in charge whose certificate of such approval and passing of the sum so payable shall be final and conclusive against the contractor. Para, all such intermediate payment shall be regarded as payment by way of advance against the final payments only and not as payments for work actually done and completed and shall not precluded and the engineer in charge from requiring bad, unsound, imperfect or unskilled work to be removed and taken away and reconstructed or re-erected, nor shall any such payment be considered as an admission of the due performance of the contract or any part thereof in any respect of the occurring of any claim, nor shall it conclude, determine or effect any way of the powers of the engineer in charge as to the final settlement and adjustment of the accounts of otherwise or in any other way vary or affect the contract. The final bills shall be submitted by the contractor within 1 month of the date fixed for completion of the work. Otherwise, the engineer in charge certificate of the measurement and of the total amount payable for the work shall be final and binding on all parties. Thera, a bill shall be submitted by the contractor each month on or before the date fixed by the engineer in charge for all work executed in the previous months, and the engineer in charge shall take or caused to be taken the requisite measurement for the purpose of having the same verified, and the claim so far as it is admissible shall be adjusted if possible within 10 days from the presentation of the bill. If the contractor does not submit the bill within the time fixed as aforesaid, the engineer in charge may depute a subordinate to measure up the said work in the presence of the contractor or his duly authorized agent, whose counter signature to the measurement list shall be sufficient warrant, and the engineer in charge may prepare a bill from such list which shall be binding on the contractor in all respects. It is the stand of the state and accepted by the High Court that the plaintiff firm has not fully complied with clause 8 and 10 of the agreement. It is also their stand that mere endorsement to the effect that the plaintiff has been accepting the amount as per final bill under protest without disclosing real grievances on merits, it is not sufficient, and it amounts to accepting the final bill without any valid objection and grievance on merits by the plaintiff. The High Court has also accepted the claim of the state that by the conduct of the plaintiff in accepting the final bill, the department has made full payment to the plaintiff, sending statutory notice and filing suit for recovery of the differential amount buried by principle of stop.